A Philippine lawmaker files a measure pushing for a 35-hour weekly work scheme. Albay 2nd District Representative Joey Salceda believes his bill will improve productivity in workplaces and make offices a healthier environment for employees. Under his measure, companies can implement reduced operating hours as an alternative working arrangement. The terms and conditions should be mutually agreed upon, including arrangements for flexible working time. Salceda also proposes the same for government employees. The Rural Missionaries of the Philippines asks the government to unfreeze its bank account so it can continue serving the poor. Members of the church-based group were recently indicted for alleged terrorist financing, but RMP denies this. It also condemns efforts to red tag them, saying such actions put their members at risk.
Masyadong mahirap sa isipin na tayo tumutulong ni red tag. At ang pinutulungan namin ay ang mga magsasaka, yung mga indigenous people, no? Tsaka yung mga nakatira sa malayo. Pero hindi ibig sabihin na pag may gumagawa ng pagsisira sa mission namin, pag-stop na tayo. No, tuloy pa rin ang pagtulong sa kapwa. Nandoon ang pangamba, no? Hindi yan nawawala. Pero naniniwala kami na ang Diyos ay nasa amin. No?
The group adds this is not the first time they've been harassed.
We still remember Father Faes. He is our RMP member. He was killed. He was shot when he was coming home to after accompanying a prisoner, political prisoner, released already. Second, we have Sister Patricia Fox, a former national coordinator of the Rural Missionaries of the Philippines. And she has battled, you know, a deportation case, and this was successful, and we know that she has been deported. And that's why we are asking, why does this government really are seemingly putting all its resources at its disposal to shut down an organization of missionaries?
The visit of U.S. lawmakers who detained former Senator Laila de Lima pushes through. De Lima's camp confirmed it went ahead this morning after the U.S. delegation secured permission from local courts. On Thursday, police barred U.S. lawmakers, led by Senator Edward Markey, from visiting de Lima in Camp Crame, saying a court permission was needed. Markey has been vocal in calling for de Lima's release. Back in 2019, he was even banned by former President Rodrigo Duterte from entering the country after he sponsored a resolution barring Philippine officials involved in de Lima's detention from entering the U.S. Now, the U.S. congressional delegation also met with Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Thursday. Marcos shared photos of the courtesy call on social media. He said he's looking forward to continuing Manila's partnership with Washington in various areas, including agriculture and economic reform.